So I'm sitting here with Joe Juhnke from Tanagram, and you presented here at COFES. Why don't you first tell folks what you do at Tanagram? What does the company do?
So Tanagram is a small shop, but we design and build software for the digital frontier. We spend a lot of time thinking about applications that don't exist and should exist and how users accept them. We have a whole program focused around the consumer adoption.
And what were you here to share? I mean, I know the subject was augmented reality, but can you share a little bit of what you were showing the audience?
So Brad Holtz, the founder, organizer, king of the hill here, he met me at ARE, which is the augmented reality event, last year, and we were showing one of our research grants developing a head-mounted display, like glasses, for augmented reality. And we were specifically developing it for the military, but he was really impressed with the way I presented and the types of things we were talking about, so we got together and talked about how I could kind of stir things up here. And so I brought a presentation talking about what we're working on as well as what we see the future of augmented reality
being. Okay. And you shared a number of different industry examples. I remember a BIM one with a building and some related to PLM. Can you share a little bit more about kind of the PLM use cases where you see this?
Absolutely, absolutely. So PLM, product lifecycle management, is, to me, not a PLM expert, is about dealing with information full cycle from the idea through the, well, frankly, end of its lifespan. What I'm talking about with augmented reality is we really have the idea that data can be superimposed onto reality in any environment, and our data is context relevant, and it's rich and deep, and that's where it gets pretty exciting. Information that allows you to drill. So just having the ability to look at a part and see on the part, staring at it for 10 seconds, you get a little message that says, hey, do you want to know more, type of thing, and you can activate that, and you can start to drill into who touched that part, and you can talk about where that part came from, and it's a material makeup, and you can actually, this is my favorite part, you can contribute to that part. You can say that it doesn't quite fit and send it back up the line, and it's really taking all of the digital work that we've done building the world of PLM and bringing it into reality.
Okay. And I think you touched on something towards the end, because there was a Q&A that I really wanted you to emphasize, that because for years ago, even maybe 10 years ago, they started to do these different virtual reality centers, and some places are called caves. Mm-hmm. Very expensive but very useful places where people can view physical prototypes in 3D. And so tell me how what you guys are doing today in augmented reality is different from that.
So technology. The idea, it's actually been called mixed media for a long time, or mixed reality. And augmented reality is a little bit of a buzzwordy kind of name. But it still stands. It's taking reality and augmenting it. What's the difference between what we have, what we're developing, and what existed? Primarily mobility. The devices we have are worn on the user. They superimpose data here onto the world, and they allow me to move around objects. I wanted to get into a whole discussion about the types of objects you can move around, but just imagine like a 3D tree, like an avatar, right? Something that you can walk around and see from different angles, and your colleagues can also do the same thing. And this has been a challenge in some of the other display technologies, but cost is huge. We're developing on platforms that are going to be sub $10,000 to start, and quickly go down as they commoditize. And you know, caves are—they have a lot more zeros after them.
So this was your first time at COFES. Mm-hmm. Tell me what you're taking away from this event.
I gotta say, I was really surprised. I had a really different expectation, and I came here and I met people that are on the forefront of some of the technology that we've been dealing with, and we've had some really great brainstorms. I've connected with people who have great business ideas and are looking to explore it. And I mean, some of the things we're talking about are insane in a great way. It's been the best conference this year. Seriously, I'm not kissing Brad's butt right now. The best conference I've been to this year.
All right, great. Thanks, Joe.